Over the past 12 months, I've raised over $5 million of investor money for our various projects. How did I do that? And more importantly, how can you do that? Stick around until the end of the video where I'll share my favorite hack to get investors to say yes to your deals every single time. Hey, what's up? Darren Voros here. My mission is to help 1,000 people create $1 million of net worth with real estate investing. Subscribe not to miss what's coming. I truly believe that anyone can raise money regardless of their real estate investing experience. The secret to being able to ask investors for money is that they have to know, like, and trust you. If you have these three qualities, it will be much easier to get people to say yes to handing over their hard-earned dollars. So let's break this down. The first thing you want to focus on is getting people to know you. What is the first thing that most people do when they are researching anything nowadays? Yeah, they go to Google and they punch in either your name or your company name or both. If you don't have a website, this is going to be a huge problem. You have to ask yourself, would you invest your money with someone who doesn't even have a website? Along with your website, you should have some basic branding. A logo, an email address specific to your business, or in other words, not a Gmail or Hotmail address, and something as simple as an email signature can go a long way. I'm not saying you have to go out and spend thousands of dollars on logos, branding, business cards, and a website. Many of these items you can do yourself for relatively low cost. If you're not familiar with products like Canva or DIY websites like Squarespace, I'll leave a link in the description below for these. Or if you want to hire someone, you can also look at services like Fiverr and Upwork. After you've got your basic branding down, now you want to start to build your presence for people to get to know you. I would focus on building your presence on multiple platforms, such as Facebook, Instagram, LinkedIn, YouTube, or TikTok. This may sound like a lot, but you can easily repurpose content for multiple social media platforms. If social media is not your thing, that's okay too. You can write blogs, create an ebook, or start an email campaign as an alternative. Another very effective way to get investors to know you is to create a community. Things like meetups or Facebook groups can be a great way to get started. If you want to take that to the next level, you could run events or even start something like a mastermind. I personally use all of these strategies, and all of these were created for multiple reasons, but one of the main reasons was for potential investors to get to know me. If you have no interest in building communities, the alternative is to be an active part of someone else's community. Sometimes this is as effective and much less work and responsibility. Go to the launch of a pre-construction condo project. Attend education seminars and networking events that are specific to real estate investing. If you want to get outside of real estate investing events to find potential investors, go to charity events, or you may even want to get on the board of directors of a local nonprofit. Who's on the board of directors of nonprofits generally? Wealthy individuals who may be looking to invest in real estate. You can also join various clubs like a tennis club, golf club, or if you're a real baller, a yacht club. These are great places for people to get to know you and your business, and in a lot of cases, the money you spend to be a part of these kinds of clubs will easily be earned back with potential investors on your projects. The final piece of the puzzle when it comes to getting people to know you is to learn how to network properly or effectively. The first thing I would suggest is coming up with a unique title for what you do. This is not your elevator pitch. This is simply the answer to the question, what do you do for a living? For example, a lot of people identify themselves as real estate investors, but when you do that, others hear one of three things. They either think you are a realtor, a slumlord, or you flip properties for a living. Not that there's anything wrong with being a realtor or flipping properties, but that's not what I do. When I changed my answer to even something as simple as I'm a real estate developer, the response I got was different. The other answer I use is I buy apartment buildings or I build apartment buildings. A couple of other tips when it comes to networking: be engaged. Pay attention to what people are saying. We generally like people who ask us questions and who listen to us. So try to listen more than you speak and ask good quality questions about the person and their interests. The other thing that can't be understated is not to wear out your welcome. I've been trapped at many networking events by people who want to monopolize my time. Pay attention to someone's body language, and if the conversation seems to be waning or they seem distracted, take the opportunity to thank them for their time and move on to meeting some other people. The second part of people getting to know, like, and trust you is getting your potential investors to like you. What makes people like you? Well, think about the people that you like in your life and what the qualities are that you specifically like about them. Usually what it boils down to is that the people that you like are providing some value in your lives. They're good conversationalists, they make you laugh, or they help you out with certain things. Believe it or not, this can be simplified into one basic premise. Lead with service. If you can provide value to someone either by sharing your experiences or by connecting them to someone else who can help them, this can be a huge asset to building your relationship and getting people to like you. It's also very important to be authentic. We also generally like people that we have things in common with. So when you're networking or getting to know people, find out what their interests are. Maybe you're going to bond over your love for French pastries, the fact that you both have kids, or your love for dogs or cats. Okay, I take that last part back. No one really likes cats, do they? I'm kidding, I love all animals. And that was an example of how you get people not to like you, by alienating them, so be careful with that too. There's another element that can come into play often when it comes time to raising capital, and that is what we call an abundance mindset. Some investors believe that if you are raising capital and they are raising capital, for every dollar that you raise, that's one less dollar that's available for them. That's called a scarcity mindset, and I see it in real estate all the time. People hoarding contacts, deals, or investors. If you want people to like you, create an abundance mindset and you'll be amazed at what kind of return that can generate. I recently passed over a bunch of names of potential investors to a friend of mine because he was actively raising capital for a deal. That kind of abundance mindset, in my experience, pays itself back in dividends over time, and it is a fantastic way for people to get to like you. And the third element you need in order to be able to raise capital effectively is to get people to trust you. This is undoubtedly the hardest one. The reason it can be difficult is because it requires us to show off what we do as investors. The balance comes in when we can do this without it coming across as bragging. Again, if we go back to that leading with service, this is where it can become very effective. So instead of walking someone around one of your projects and boasting how amazing it is, it's better to walk someone around a project and educate them on why you made the choices that you did, why the project has been a success, or potentially some challenges you faced. This is still getting people to trust you and getting to show off what you're doing in your real estate investing business, but it also comes from a very humble place. The other thing you can do is share accolades, or in other words, any awards you may have received. But instead of just showing off the award, it's nice to explain what you did in order to achieve that award and how people can see similar results if they follow a pattern or a process. It's also important that you stay consistent with not only what you share, but when you share it. If you make a Facebook post once a year about your projects that you're working on, it's difficult for investors to trust you. But if you post once a week and let them know what you're up to, the trust factor goes up significantly. Creating consistency in what you share builds trust because your followers will rely on your content coming out at certain intervals. And whether they realize it or not, they will become dependent on it. That's why I release videos every week at the same time. My audience trusts that I will keep my schedule, and they trust that if they give up their time in their day to watch my content, it will be the quality they've come to expect. As promised, I wanted to share one of my favorite hacks when it comes to getting people to know, like, and trust you, and that is to share not only your wins, but also your struggles and your challenges. Real estate investing is hard, and it doesn't always go as planned. Anyone who is putting themselves out there and is only showing you their massive successes and how much money they've made is not being entirely truthful. Every investor that I know has lost money, or at some point definitely hasn't made as much as they were expecting, and without a doubt, they've also run into some challenges and stressful times as a real estate investor. If you can share these items with other people, that will help build your credibility, authenticity, and transparency. These are all huge when it comes to asking people to invest with you. Once investors know, like, and trust you, and they are interested in investing their money with you, the rest boils down to your process, your communication, and your follow-up. But that's a video for another day. If you're looking for additional resources related to real estate investing and raising capital, you can always check out my website at darrenvoros.com. If you have questions related to raising capital or any other real estate investing questions, feel free to drop those in the comment section below. Feel free to follow me on Facebook and Instagram, where I post regularly. Thanks for watching, and we'll see you next Tuesday.